Previously, the group fought the molten glass elemental and the minions that it called to join it. They managed to cool it down enough to solidify it, although it heated up again and the process had to be repeated. The elemental attempted to turn both Ingrid and Lacey into Snow White, but they managed to get themselves free after being engulfed inside what was essentially a glass coffin. Eventually, they managed to defeat the elemental, which shattered into lots of little pieces of glass. A piece of crystal tied to the seam remained behind, prompting a bit of an argument between Will and Ingrid. Two people who worked in the shop they were in eventually came out and tried to lie their way out of what had happened. Arin didn't appreciate that, and they cursed them to cough up flowers every time they lied. One of them told the group that they'd been given the crystal by someone wearing a bright purple scarf, one of a group called the Perps. They believed they were smugglers of some type that worked around the waterfront. They'd been told it would give them a one-up on the Ardens, and they'd taken advantage of it. If the group wanted to find the man who'd given them the crystal, they could find him at the High Tide Inn. He agreed to go tell the Ardens what had happened if they agreed not to get the guards involved. The group told him that would be between him and the Ardens. Speaking of the Ardens, they gave the group 200 gold as well as a token of favor. The group would be able to make one request from the family in the future. They were also hired to look into the Perps and see what they could find out. The group was told to go to the Old Oak Inn and mention that they were working for the Ardens. They'd at least get one night free at the inn if they did. As they got ready to leave, Ingrid asked Obsidian and Will, who she clearly saw as the two most untrustworthy of the group, whether they knew of anyone called the Perps. Neither of them did, although Obsidian suspected they might be keeping things on the down low if they weren't working for the Thieves Guild. The group headed out, and Obsidian took them to a nearby food stall called the Barking Dog that had a rivalry with a stall across the street in a very Pats and Geno's type of way. They were very disappointed that there was a poetry reading happening nearby that was cutting down on all of the usual chaos. After they got some food and moved on, the group made their way to the Old Oak Inn. The inn was run by a retired adventuring group called the Keepers, who were very familiar to the players for some odd reason. It was almost like it was their former characters from a different campaign or something. Weird, huh? The group got a room for the night and went upstairs to drop off all their things. Then they headed back down to talk and plan on what to do next. There was some back and forth as Will told them more about what he knew about the syndicate and the seam, but they didn't come up with any proper plan. The next day, the group split up, which has never once ended badly. Arin went shopping for some spell components, and they ended up also leaving with a wand that shot fish at people. Meanwhile, Ingrid, Lacey, and Obsidian arrived at the tavern they'd gone to two nights before for trivia. They spoke to the tavern keeper, and Ingrid explained that she wanted to hire someone to do some research for them in the library. The tavern keeper told them that she knew a university student who could use the extra money, and the three of them had some drinks and waited for the student to show up. Elsewhere, Will came across a cloaked figure who asked him if he wanted to play some dice or cards. Will recognized the voice, and he agreed to play cards. A conversation full of double language and vague references then ensued, and it was clear that the cloaked figure was some type of mentor figure to him, who saw him as an investment. Will was told to watch what he said to the witch, referring to someone who worked in the shop that Will was heading towards. It was also suggested that he make sure she never meet Arin. Once they were done talking, the figure shifted. While it was the same body, the mysteriousness disappeared, and it was just an old man who seemed to be waking up from a nap. Will told him he'd just been checking on him before moving on. Shortly afterwards, he arrived outside the shop he'd come to visit. And that is where we left off.